My presentation is focused on how to engage political and economical support on urban health well-being at the local level, the case of Moldova. And I will start with a demonstration that we have this political support in the presence of State Secretary of Ministry of Health of Moldova, Ms. Alena Serbulenko, the Deputy Director of Public Health Agency, Vasily Gushtyuk, two Vice Presidents of the municipalities, Gabriela Zhelezny and Ala Ungurian, that we are working together on implementation of this Healthy Life project. We are working all, especially in 10 districts, and focused on preventing and control on, at the moment of non-communicable disease. Of course, I would like to express thanks on behalf of Swiss Development and Cooperation and Swiss Tropical and Public Health Institute from Basel that we are working on. So regarding the Moldova, who doesn't know, the country is situated between Romania and Ukraine. We have 36 districts, but economically divided in three regions, north, center, and south part. According to the program on universal coverage, the profiles of the Republic of Moldova, so starting from 2004, we implement the health insurance mandatory, and the government start to reform the health system. So you can see some numbers here. The number of population is 3.5 million. The life expectancy is 71 years. Unfortunately, the health expenditure is just $500. At the same time, we are happy to mention that the government engaged and spent increasing percent of money from the budget. For example, from 2000 to until 2014, it was increased twice, from 6% to 13. But in the same time, the out of the pocket is about 40%. Other figures, of course, the population getting elder and elder, and in comparison, the ratio to workers to the pensioner, you can see from 1990s, 5.8, and is going to go to the 2.1. About life expectancies, I mentioned about this before, and you can see the structure of death by major disease. Of course, it is international, and you can see that non-communicable disease consists 87%. Mainly cardiovascular disease. And the pyramid, age pyramid, you can see that the population getting elder and elder. At the national level, of course, having international support of World Health Organization and Swiss Cooperation Development Bureau with the Ministry of Health, we develop a national agenda for reducing the burden of non-communicable disease, focused on these four components: the development of national framework on prevention and control on NCDs. And as you can see, the main point is strengthening multi-sectorial activities. Without that, no success. Yes, focusing on reducing the impact of modifiable risk factors, tobacco, nutrition, alcohol, physical inactivities, strengthening the capacity of the system on prevention and control, and note the main point is to strengthen the component of health promotion, that I'm involved directly on this, to increase the responsibility of the citizens. And this is really a challenge due to the fact that population just use that the health system is due, is mandatory to offer the services, and but the responsibility of the citizens is using somebody else, not by himself. So regarding the framework, of legal framework, we have a council at the country level involving the ministers, universities, NGOs, and of course international donors, developed a lot of national programs, and you can see here on tobacco, alcohol, nutrition, diabetes, mental health, cardiovascular disease, iron and folic acid, iodine deficiency. Everything is mentioned in the legislation. The main point is how to implement. And we decide to promote the World Health Organization policy, so health in all policies, focus on co-production of the result through the multi-sectorial action. Of course, to explain and involving them, to mention about the benefits for all other sectors, not just health, to benefits of the goal of the entire society, and finally to benefit of health. Addressing the health determinants, everybody knows in this room, so we have to work at the social level, not just on health, but socio-economical, cultural, environmental condition, and also at the individual level. So practically what we did. Started from 2014, the Ministry of Health, with the support of international donors, we developed a national guide on health profiles, structured with a description of the district, we call Rayon, demographic and social economical context, population health status, risk factors on health promotion, life and work environment, infrastructure of health services, and explain the role of health profiles. And you can see the idea is to improve the link between local authority, institutional services, motivate inter-institutional and intersectorial cooperation, so help local authority to create a common value at the community level and empower the community by identifying their needs for health, improving the efficiency of planning, and it is good to mention that the main topic of our conference is learning from experience, planning for the future. It is exactly what we are working on the local level, based on health profiles, to develop action plans, evidence-based, just according to the needs and the expectancies of the citizens. So, they synchronize the decision, strengthen the partnership and cooperation between different community representatives. And by the way, we are working now to identify the group, local interest group, and to motivate them to work with the local, with mayors and local authority on this point. Stimulate community participation, by the way, and enhance skills and legitimacy of the local government authority. We work closely with the Public Health Institute from Ljubljana, and Slovenian experts came to Moldova with the support of Switch Development and Cooperation Bureau, and we piloted the methodology based on UNDP model. As you can see, there is core issues that we approach. This is the institutional arrangement, leadership, knowledge, and accountability, and point of entries. That depends of the environmental, organizational, and individual capacity, also functional capacity, functional capacity that it's about engage stakeholders, assess the situation, create the vision and the mandate, formulate the policy, budget management, and evaluate. This is based on the international, but we applied this at the local level and identify that environmental level, legislative basis, as you saw already, we have and we create a regional public health council, territorial public health council. Of course, you know, you mentioned about the infectious disease, and we create the commission for emergency public health, but it, and another situation for disasters. Of course, we have at the local level these commissions, but everything is when it is emergency. So now we succeed to develop this capacity to have this platform that is transparency, that is participatory way from different sectors, from different actors, the local level, with the support of Ministry of Health, of course, but in the presence of Vice President of the Municipality Councils, that are taking care about this communication, but of course with the professional support in the local level with the support of public health agency. So we identify the clear procedure, financial incentive for prevention that should be discussed at this regional public health, administrative structure, strong political support and will, and we see this regional public health council as a coordination platform. It is not a state organization, this is a platform just to discuss and according to the needs of local population. So we create this environmental organizational level. At the organizational level, we create the infrastructure and these intellectual resources and improve the awareness about NCDs and risk factors. Of course, promoting the champions from the individuals and to increase awareness about NCD and risk factors on the population and the community, and promoting that the community well-being values. In this context, we together with the public health school and with the support of Minister of Health and the vice presidents at the district level, we organize training of LPA representatives and decentralized services of the government that are working at the district level. Of course, you can see the summary of this. We talk about health system, public health, operation, public health, non-communicable disease, and health and all policies. Of course, giving the examples of Northern Karelia and promoting health profiles development as an instrument to develop action plans, evidence-based, according to the needs of population. In continuing work, we organize a training of the members of the regional public health councils on how to plan successful. So developing different grants, proposal, projects, and SDC supported these grants. You can see here some pictures that the working group demonstration and promoting the small grant proposals. Lessons learned. Of course, the financial issues is a problem. But the main lessons learned is to understand that each sector actually what task they have in the community, what they are doing now at the moment, and to think how through can they promote health through their routine activities. And of course that things anyway will cut it out. In this way, we're going to avoid not just, as I mentioned, ad hoc activities and emergency situation, but to facilitate regularly and to make it to become institutionalized. I'd like to express knowledge to the all organizations involved, Ministry of Health, National Agency for Public Health, Local Authority, University, School of Public Health, all health organizations, and this is our team. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.